So to accelerate growth, should all our IT move to the cloud?
Well, it isn't right for everything. The cloud would give us more flexibility, but we lose control.
Should we stay? Should we go?
We have to act in real time. And we need business insights across all our data silos, but...
Can you check if I'm live, bro?
On YouTube?
Yeah.
Wait, we can stay and go. HPE GreenLake is the platform that brings the cloud to us.
And it'll accelerate
our digital transformation? Absolutely. Should I stay or should I go now?
Rated E for everyone.
Left-hander Brooks Raley takes over here in the bottom of the sixth inning. 2-0 Houston here in game four. And Orlando Arcia is at the plate.
Yeah, you are.
Bet. He bats for Martin. And goes after the first Turn pitch, around. Lines it into right for Brantley. One pitch, one out. Raley takes over for Stanek, who pitched a perfect inning with a strikeout. And Eddie Rosario will take his time coming to the plate. Got a lefty here, a lefty on deck, and then the switch inning, Ozzy Albies. There is action for Houston out in their bullpen.
What the fuck? Bro, I'm just clickbaiting the shit out of people with my title.
What are you saying?
James Dean, 2021 Formula Drift. That fool was not in Formula Drift in 2021.
Oh, I just got fucking joked so hard.
That's not Ulu.
You are James Dean in the flesh.
Literally. Bro, I swear to God I could drift, bro.
Three. this postseason for Eddie Rosario. Added on the 30th of July, and now Maldonado is going to go out and talk. Brooks Raley trying to pitch around that one-out double. Freeman looking for something to smoke. Good pitch, 3-2. That'll be it for Raley. With all these coming up, Phil Maton is coming in.
You probably think Visa is a credit card company, huh? But it's actually a network. Connecting just about everyone. It can open up a cup of coffee and change minds about what makes a business a business. And it is working to connect everyone. So, make Visa a network working for everyone.
Indeed Business. Job searching with Stress.
Let's do this. Before you get in the game, make sure your stats are up to date. Then, it's all about focus. Max focus. Yes!
This guy is really weird.
There are beautiful ideas
cloud experience, you have the flexibility you need to unveil them to the world.
Oh, I got stuck between a build.
Oh. Told
you, Raiders. Keep asking, I'm gonna say no.
He doesn't like it in, and he struggles with curveballs. What does Phil Maton do? He throws a lot of fastballs up and a lot of curveballs. Rosario, the lead runner, Freddie Freeman behind him. One out. Maton spins it in, and a breaking ball fouled by Albies. Phil Maton, 22 inherited runners with the Astros, only six scored in the regular season. The postseason, that's 27%. The MLB average is 35%. Now, again, the way that the Astros are playing defense against Albies, they would have a hard time keeping Rosario close. You see where Correa is. Look how far away he is from the bag. So he's going to try his best to keep him there, but you could almost feel like you get a huge lead. With Bregman playing in, of course, and away from the bag, you just don't see too many teams take chances on stealing, especially in a high leverage situation with the hitter at the plate. Maton started his year in Cleveland, ends his year in the World Series with Houston. Traded in July as he gets it by the bat of Albies, strike two. There's the high fastball. Albies has that uppercut swing. Throws it, and you just see where his hands in the barrel gets underneath the bat. And again, it's not 98, but it's the angle at which he throws.
You're gonna hit it?
Now a 1-2. 2-2. Two pitch is outside, a full count. Again, a situation where we've seen it before. They didn't send the runners, and Albies struck out yesterday. But even if they send him, I don't think, unless they throw behind, meaning try to get Freeman, but Freeman would have too big of a lead anyways. Here's a 3-2, runners don't go, and a foul at the plate.
runners stay put. Albies strikes out. Two down as Maton got it by him. Albies 0 for 3 tonight. Scouting report executed perfectly. It took a 3-2 pitch, but he threw another high fastball, and again, Albies from the left side just can't get the barrel. Doesn't have that particular swing. See how he tries, but gets underneath it. This guy has this kind of swing, though.
And this guy's gotten some big hits for the Braves this postseason. Austin Riley. Two on, two out. Strike one. Two homers, seven RBIs this postseason. Had one of the two runs batted in last night in the game 3 win. Riley trying to deliver with two out. He checked his swing, a ball and a strike.
What? Pepperoni.
Brownie pizza?
Pepperoni. Yeah.
Is it like pepperoni?
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna eat it all.
Go ahead.
I'm going fishing tonight, Ro.
You are?
Yeah.
What time?
Like fucking 10.
Sheesh. Deep sea fishing?
No, just like Santee Lakes type shit.
It's only.
A ball and two strikes on Austin Riley. And a check swing didn't go again. 2-2. Mike Malinsky, the first base umpire, has been asked twice.
Yo.
Your first move is like that, and I know Yo. It's a check swing, but you're not going to hit it. To get on top of that fastball.
Wait, so... Do you have the stizzy or no?
2-2 pitch now. There's a shot.
Damn, P.
Alvarez plays it on a bounce. Throws to the plate. Too late. Other runners advance. Safe. And it's
you said what?
RBI by Riley.
Where? Damn, all right.
And this one caught the middle of the plate. You see how it pops out of his
Fuck.
Right there.
Huh?
He stays back and delivers a good ball to left field.
Lambo.
I
don't think so, Rock, because I got to go to fucking Dayton anyway, bro.
And they want to see if Altuve had the glove on Riley when he came off the bat. Big man,
no, I gotta go to fucking Medmen.
Takes it off and the top of the bag, and then right when he takes it,
yeah.
When I think if he would have held it a little longer, that would have been a possibility. But is the batting glove part of touching the bag? Well, that's, I mean,
yeah, it's boo rail.
Here hangs in the balance. It's a one run game.
Oh, really?
Score. Runs there. Prior to this play, but
whoopster.
See where he comes off, that's when the tag comes off of Riley. See, he's still on. Now the glove comes off, and I personally don't think it's something they could, unless there's a different angle, but a huge hit to at least cut the deficit to 2-1.
I agree. It looks like Riley goes past the bag, the glove comes off his back. And he is safe. And it's second and third, and Yordan Alvarez threw to the plate, didn't have any chance to get Rosario, and the throw just kind of died in the middle of the infield. And both runners are able to advance. Now a base hit could put Atlanta on top for the first time tonight.
Yeah, he gets this ball and he goes straight forward and throws this ball. Don't know where the cutoff man was. And that's why Maldonado came flying up to try to cut the runner down at second base.
Now they're going to intentionally pass Jock Peterson and pitch to D'Arnaud. Austin Riley just keeps getting big hit after big hit for Atlanta. The lead has been cut in half, and now the bases are loaded, two outs for D'Arnaud, who moved up in the lineup tonight. And what a spot for him in the Atlanta Braves. There have been no lead changes in this World Series yet in a ball game, as the first one misses down and away.
The hard part here for D'Arnaud, wanting to do something right with the bases loaded. Saw the first power breaking ball away. Can he stay off the high fastball if that's where Maton tries to go with a lot of his fastballs?
We asked manager Brian Snitker why D'Arnaud moved up. Was it because of the home run last night? He said, yeah, he's just starting to get settled in. Missed a lot of time with that torn ligament in his left thumb. He likes the way he's swinging the bat. And here he is. A 1-0 from Maton. Big swing. One ball, one strike. Those 10 runners on by the Astros through six innings. Hanging over them right now. Strike two.
D'Arnaud's swing just way too big right there for a breaking ball over the middle of the plate. And with two strikes, we'll see if he shortens up just a little bit. This is a huge swing, high leg kick, and then just a mammoth swing. You see his head pull out. Bench knew like that might have been the pitch.
1-2 pitch. Only been one grand slam during a World Series game by a catcher, the great Yogi Berra, back in 1956, Game 2. Don Newcomb. One and two, the count on D'Arnaud. Got him looking with a fastball right down the middle. The Braves get on the board. Now they leave the bases loaded and have stranded five on the night. Long half inning. Atlanta gets one. Astros up one. Back after this from your local Fox station.
After the World Series,
we said we were going to play.
The singer would be sent home immediately.
An all-new Masked Singer returns after the World Series on Fox.
We go in there and lock the door right behind us.
I don't know how much time we have before the rioters are coming for us.
Nightmare Drive, all-new Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox, or watch anytime.
We'll be right back.
anytime, hon.
Play the Kentucky Lottery online, anywhere, anytime.
I won! Yes!
More games, more chances to win. Anytime is playtime.
Nice first.
When you walk in the door with the new triple bacon pizza from Papa John's, oh, that smell of bacony goodness has everything. It's the season of bacon at Papa John's.
I lost my son due to extreme negligence. Mother's instinct just flared up in me. And that's why I reached out to Morgan and Morgan. When I saw my attorney come through the doors on my behalf, it was amazing. He went right after and he showed them that they were wrong.
Life of 33 years. We lost Michael Johnson today and we're crushed, but we also know we'll see him again and that sustains us. There isn't anybody who's ever met Ernie or anybody in that family for that matter that doesn't walk away better off for it, and considering Ernie a friend, and we just send our best.
Yeah, absolutely. Got a chance to work with Ernie when I got into this business. And Michael, his son, knew everybody by the car they drove. Every time you met him, he'd say, John Smoltz, silver Lexus, black interior. Every person by the car he drove, and special, special person.
Yep, thinking of you. Johnson family, as Matzik takes over here in the seventh inning. Yordan Alvarez at the plate, one ball, one strike. Strike two, Matzik has just been absolutely lights out, tremendous for the Atlanta Braves over the past 2 years. In the postseason, he's been virtually untouchable.
He's gone to another level. His fastball has taken hitters by storm. I haven't seen hardly anybody score him up. And he's been a big reason, again, why Braves been so good in the postseason.
Swanson stays down on it. Gets the out. National League Championship Series Game 6, which was the deciding game, came in second and third. Nobody out. Up by two. Struck out Pujols, Souza, and Betts. And was fired up. And then World Series Game 3 last night. He did his thing. Getting the three outs and getting this game, that game, into the ninth. At the time, leading by one. A home run by Darno, a 2-0 win to go up 2-1 for Atlanta. Correa now 1-for-3 on the night. He and his double play partner have the two RBIs. Altuve a home run in the fourth, and that's the difference in the game right now.
Now, both teams knew when they came into this series. Well, Houston for sure knew they didn't have their best starter. Atlanta didn't know they were going to lose theirs in game one. But they were going to rely heavily on the bullpen. And you could honestly say it was going to be a matchup of the bullpens, because nobody, with the exception of maybe Max Fried, for the Braves, seemed to have will be able to pitch deep into the game.
One ball, one strike. One out, nobody on here in the seventh. Correa grounds to third. Riley. Two out. Christian Javier is getting ready for the Astros in their bullpen. And more in the category of a starter slash middle reliever, but as you said early on, Dusty Baker's going to go with his big arms, and tonight that includes number 53.
And all of it will be worth it if they get the victory. It'll certainly hurt if they don't, because then tomorrow, you know, they'll have to scratch and crawl to get that victory. You know, they're looking at not only getting the victory today, but tomorrow to go home up 3-2. But at the very least, they've got to be able to get a victory to go home down 3-2.
Two out, nobody on for Tucker. Line drive into left over the outstretched glove of Riley. And a two-out single for Kyle Tucker. He's 2-for-4. That'll bring in Gurriel.
He has the swing for every kind of pitch that he sees. Very simple. Almost feels like a one-piece swing where there's not many flaws to it. See how it gets the back of the barrel through the zone.
Gurriel happy to get a chance to swing the bat. Intentionally walked his last two times up. Grounded out. Back to Kyle Wright in the second. So 0-for-1. Takes a ball. Manager Brian Snitker not worried one bit if he has to use his big three, big four relievers three straight games. Said Matzik's good to go tonight, and he will be good to go tomorrow as he pours in a 97-mile-an-hour fastball for strike one.
Yeah, the question will be if the Braves bat in the bottom of the seventh and they tie it up or the score's the same, will he go out for the eighth or will it just be a one-inning appearance?
Likely one-inning as a fly ball goes into right and will send us into the seventh inning stretch. Matzik hangs up another zero. What a postseason he's had. 2-1 Houston after 6.5.
It's never been easy to stay in touch, so we never miss the chance to show how much we care. And thanks to all of you who used your MasterCard to order online or tap in store at restaurants and grocery stores, MasterCard has donated $5 million to Stand Up to Cancer. Together is how we help start something priceless.
On November 5th, the Marvel Cinematic Event.
Psoriatic arthritis made my joints stiff, swollen, painful.
Tremfya is approved to help reduce joint symptoms in adults with active psoriatic arthritis. Some patients even felt less fatigued.
Serious allergic reactions may occur. Tremfya may increase your risk of infections and lower your ability to fight them. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, or if you had a vaccine or plan to.
Tremfya. Emerge Tremfyant. Janssen can help you explore cost support options.
Holy shit.
Sebastian Javier is into the action. Made 9 starts during the regular season. 25 times out of the bullpen. And he is unscored upon here in this postseason. He's looked really good when he's had a chance to pitch.
So he's doing pretty good. I thought there for a second the way this game could go differently, we would see him. At an earlier stage, but nonetheless, he's in here at 7.
Duvall 1-for-2. Takes a strike. Duvall and Swanson then likely a pinch hitter. Action with Luke Jackson, the right-hander, getting loose for Atlanta in their bullpen. After Matzik threw a scoreless 7. That's down. One ball, one strike.
When it's just safe to do so.
Great live action to his arm. Fastball slider combination. The right-handers, they have a hard time differentiating between the two.
Down
to again that power arms for the right-handers in the Braves lineup, and the right-handers that come out of Houston's pen.
1-2 now. Is down at 96. 2-2. Situation presents itself, and now 2 quick strikes on Swanson. There's Presley. We're only in the 7th.
Yeah, it's going to be the highest leverage situation for the lineup that's going to come up for the Astros and Dusty Baker.
Fly ball into right, foul ball. And that may very well be because of that guy. Rosario. But much like when I got a chance to do our first World Series together, you know, the Cubs were down 3-1, but their pitching was lined up better than the Indians for them to come back. And I think Dusty's approaching it the same way, going, okay, the Braves don't know who we're going to pitch game 5. I know if I can win this game, I'm more than I'm set up better to win this series if I can win tonight. And that's why I think you're seeing it. Here's one into right. Against the Braves. They haven't had many of them. breaking balls. We talked about right field and how the ball jumps. Swanson, with his power, goes to right field and barely clears the wall. He doesn't care if it's by 1 inch or 40 feet. Dansby Swanson picks right now to go deep for the first time this postseason. And it's 2-2 in the seventh. He went with the fastball, and that was center cut. Even though he was late, he got enough of the barrel on it. He's played here all year. He knows the ball goes to right field, and right about there, a special feeling. But the pitches previously, he swung big and loose against the breaking ball. But that was a fastball. Over that yellow line. Back onto the field of play, a home run to tie the game. Jorge Soler bats. Ball one inside. Strange way for this game to be tied 2-2, where the Astros have had action just about every basis. On base just about every inning. Braves haven't had many opportunities, but they've cashed in the last two to tie the game. Good pitch to Soler. Big swing. One ball, one strike. Jackson's ready to go. He'll take over in the eighth. 2-1 pitch. Driven in the air to left. Back in the
great
left.
Shot, right? Dimensions, but he gave every effort he had to catch that ball. I mean, he is flying into this right here and catches the knee on the padding. Just missed the baseball. In July by Alex Anthopoulos in their front office. Soler with a home run and Rosario, who's been all world, going 2-for-3 tonight with a double and a run scored last inning. Back to back. Yeah, that breaking ball started inner half and ended in the middle, and he kind of knew he got it, but I don't think he knew it was this close. A lot of topspin. That ball was coming down, and again, Alvarez almost catches that ball. Swanson, pretty excited. Remember, Alvarez
has had surgery on both knees, played only two games last year. But now a double switch. Javier is lifted as Baker uses the double switch and will go to his bullpen, now trailing by a run here in game four.
We did it again. Verizon has been named America's most reliable network by RootMetrics. And our customers rated us number one for network quality in America, according to J.D. Power. Number one in reliability 16 times in a row. Most award for network quality 27 times in a row. Proving once again that nobody builds networks like Verizon. That's why we're building 5G right. That's why there's only one best network.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned. Smoked. Seared. Spiced. Soft. Bold. And wild. It's a whole new type of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Windows 11, it performs to another level.
Let's go!
And when it comes to streaming movies, we haven't really experienced any buffering. It's so cool that we'll have access to movie theater level quality pretty much anywhere.
Seeing it load up that quick, I was genuinely surprised.
I can't believe there's no lag. I didn't realize how bad it was until I got a really good drive.
The closer typically takes over in the seventh with Eddie Rosario. This is the matchup that Dusty Baker was eyeing, but I'm sure not thinking that he was going to be trailing by a run as it pops up here in the seventh.
Yeah, even if he gave up two hits. But the problem is those two hits were homers, so those are 2 points on the board, not trailing.
Good breaking ball from Presley to Eddie Rosario.
Balls in the game so tight, and he matches it with cutting action on his fastball.
117th World Series and the first time in the long Braves history they've gone back to back during a World Series game. 1-1 pitch here, fouled back.
Here's where Rosario likes it, I guess, giving two strikes. See his postseason numbers, they haven't dwindled at all.
One third of an inning for Christian Javier. Two runs on the two hits and left the park. One strikeout. This game just got turned upside down. Here comes a 1-2 pitch. Rosario strikes out. Two out. Two for four nights so far. Jorge Soler just became the second player in Braves history with a go-ahead home run in the seventh inning or later in the World Series game. Eddie Matthews with the other for the Milwaukee Braves. The 1957 World Series Game 4 against the Yankees. Braves won that one in seven. Freddie Freeman takes a strike. Hey. base hit for an RBI by Austin Riley. Tied up there, good pitch, strike two. Get the first run in, and then two home runs from right-handers. You want a pinch hit? Ball upstairs from Presley. Still just a one-run game. That's it. The pitcher of record now for Atlanta after going one inning long. Freeman strikes out. This place is alive and well. Oh. Swanson goes deep into right with Soler watching.
Brother, how fucking long have I been fucking muted?
Oh, wee bit.
Fuck. I'm like, Durelli must be busy or something. Must not be at a setup. You're supposed to hit back-to-back home runs to take the fucking lead.
What does that mean?
Back-to-back home runs, two home runs in a row.
Yeah, I thought you said same thing. No, some wireless companies
take back your data. No, hell no.